Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Trade Out Loud trading room. Can I please have a quick sound check? Thank you so much. Welcome, everyone, to the Trade Out Loud Futures trading room. My name is Anka Metcalf, and today's Thursday. It is July 22nd, 2021. It is 9:22 a.m. Eastern time, so let's get started. On the economic calendar this morning, we had the unemployment claims, and we saw a little bit of jitters right ahead of the numbers that came out. At 10 o'clock, we have CB lending index. We have existing home sales, and at 10:30, we have natural gas storage. So 10 o'clock is coinciding with the major reversal time into the market. And therefore, we can see some kind of pressure that may come in due to the fact that we're having these numbers that are coming out. All right, so what we have in the market right now. Okay, so we're opening the day. We're just literally 5 minutes, 7 minutes away from the open. The Dow is down barely 23 points. The S&P is down half a point. And NASDAQ is up 10 points, and we have Russell down 6.5 points. So if you look at this structure overall, the market is sideways. So it's not telling us anything. It has poked new highs in the overnight trading session. All the indices, the Dow, the S&P, NASDAQ, and also Russell. And they started to pull back, obviously, because we did have numbers coming out this morning at 8:30. And as a protective measure, day traders, and of course, algos pulled their money out. The decision is going to come shortly after 9:30, or the decision is going to come after 10 o'clock, because we have the rest of the data that is coming in at 10 o'clock. It is not high impact. However, because it is into trading into a major reversal time, it may have quite an impact on the market. We have, I'm not showing it here, but we have copper that seems to be waking up. In fact, I will put it here before we talk about these because it's accelerating right now. So we have copper that is actually waking up from a massive range on the daily. So this is the range on the daily. You can see that for most of the time we held into $4.22 and we had the shakeout. This is pretty much what I'm expecting in Bitcoin as well. So every single time when we have a range that has been lasting for a long duration of time, we could either get a spike to the upside and then the price will go down, or we get a spike to the downside and then the price will go up. I like the formation on the weekly chart. The weekly chart is ready to trigger. As you can see, we still have one obstacle. We have resistance into the $4.35. The trigger for this week is going to be $4.365. That is the trigger for it. It is a trade for bigger accounts. It will require a stop below this pivot, which is into the $4.07. The reason for its congestion into the $4.25, $4.30, $4.37, which we had as well in the prior weeks in July, is due to the fact that we have had a tremendous run up. We had 1, 2, 3, 4 up. We came back in, we sandwiched. The next bar should have taken out the high of $4.71 and should have continued higher because it was stabilizing at support. We had 4 weeks of support. And then we have the shakeout. This is what happens when you have one of these massive ranges. So you have a big shakeout. This time around, the shakeout happened in a more moderate fashion and it happened on the daily chart. And it was not as dramatic as the pullback, the shakeout that we had on June 14th. This is very interesting here. So I would like to get a little piece of it for a long, just a scale in opportunity. And by the way, Neuro, new high, guys. Neuro, new high. We also, so like I said, the entry for this, I'm going to actually post it in the room. If you have never traded copper before, it will have a really wide risk. So take it in a simulated account. If you have traded it before, then you know. Okay, so copper, this is going to be a swing trade. So copper is going to be long. And we want to get it over $4.365. We would like to place a stop right here into the 407. And we will be looking for a target, first target. First of all, we need to digest this resistance. So therefore, we will pick a first target into the $4.40. The next target we wanted into the prior support, which is $4.43. Afterwards, we're gonna look for $4.50, $4.60. So it's gonna go in small increments until we get into this area. And then once we break 460, we may start moving higher, faster into the 470. This could be a trade that may take a long time to develop, or maybe very quickly. If you recall, we had a silver trade a few months ago, and we have achieved long-term targets in a matter of days. So when it comes to these commodities, be very careful, okay? All right. Thank you, Carrie. And thank you, Ralph. Yes, Neuro had earnings before the market opened and reported sales of 2.2 million. Up from 136 million over the last year. So it's just rocking and rolling. I don't have any other watches that are exactly like Neural, like we had. I do have some watches. NVIDIA is actually popping on a scanner. So NVIDIA is on the scanner right now as pre-market mover. And it's also... it has some interest in it. I'm not seeing any block trades into it, but I thought I saw one. I thought I saw one yesterday in NVIDIA. So I'm gonna take, but anyways, really massive move in Neuro, like incredible. Okay, hold on. Let me just shut off my speakers. Okay. All right. All right, the market is open. We're going to talk about the indices in just a little bit. Okay, Ramesh, this is the September contract. The September contract. Now I don't have my swing trading account on. So gotta pop it open and then we're gonna talk about, we need the indices to calibrate anyway. So, all right. In the meantime, while I'm setting up my account, for those of you that are new, I like to separate things. So my swing trades are in one account and my day trades are in a different account. Okay. All right. Let's continue with oil. Oil has reached the 200 SMA. You could see it right here, the 200 SMA. It also has reached, take a look at the 4 hour, the 50 SMA, the declining SMA. So it had a lot of resistance, a lot of confluence resistance into this area, plus resistance from price action. And it's reacting off of that area. We do have support into the 69, 87, 85. If we reach this area, then it can possibly fall back down into the 69, 42, at which area we become bullish again. So it's going to be on watch for today. It is still levitating right now. The price is levitating above the 20 SMA. All right, so we're seeing NASDAQ a little bit higher. Like I said, NVIDIA, very bullish, Microsoft open with a gap up. So we're having some impulse into AMD is trading higher as well. Apple is trading higher, Google a little bit higher. We have Amazon a little bit higher. So we have the power stocks that are moving a little bit higher this morning. This morning, I would like to wait a little bit. We have crossed the bullish above area in NASDAQ very aggressively. We have divergency in YM and in Russell so far. NASDAQ is into a tighter range than the other indices. NASDAQ resistance is at 14,869. NASDAQ from this point on, it has initiated a daily continuation and can propel higher into the 14,950. So we have targets into the 880. We have targets into the 900. 920, 950, 980, and we have the all-time high into the 14,996. Hey, Kevin, I bet I'm not looking at it right now. You know what? I would love to look at it right now. Okay, let's see. That's a crazy stock. It is such a crazy stock. Okay, let's see what else do we have here. FCX reported earnings as well. I like to watch that in sync with copper. And it's pulling back a little bit. We had tons of earnings before the market opened. Tons. And we have a lot of companies that will be reporting after the close. Just taking a quick look. Look at the divergency. I'm still keeping the 1 hour on. See, much different structure than we had yesterday. Yesterday, we were in sync, and it was so fun to trade not one, but more indices. We have the Dow pulling back. Although it's trading on support right now, this is a decision line. You also see the 200 simple moving average, and we have linear support from prior price action. We're also having a little bit of a sell-off into the E-mini S&P. E-mini S&P is not that far from triggering a bullish above over 62. Russell meltdown, three bars down so far, violating the first level of support and approaching the second level of support right here. We do have a golden cross, which is relatively bullish into this structure. Gonna put oil on a smaller structure here to see if we can pick up a trade as well later in the day. Wanted to point out gold, no trades in gold. From the 1 hour, you can see that we have a line in the sand here, which is support. We also have some prior resistance high from Tuesday and Wednesday. We need to take out these highs before we actually determine any kind of directional bias. The 4 hour is super choppy. I'm staying away from it. From the weekly structure, you can see that we discussed it on Monday. And if we start breaking below 1790, we are going to start coming in. However, I would be very cautious because we already have a low and a higher low. And the pattern is more likely to hold the structure. So probably it may want to do a little bit of a shakeout and then pull back. So this sell is not really definite because it's into an uptrending structure. So it's just trying to rotate. It really needs to get above the 1850, 1845 to 1850 in order to have that confirmation for the upside. So far the support is into the 1753. I would say, if we were to watch this on a smaller structure, because this is a weekly, if we see any weakness into it, we may look into a day trade. So we can't possibly, it can be bearish under 1790 and with a follow through. Now, of course, this is a really higher time frame, but the follow through probably can be into the 80s and upper 70s for that. There's a new stock in town right now that is taking the lead for today, up 71%. The stock is PRFX. PRFX, 7 million shares traded, 1 hour rotation has already triggered. I like to look at stocks or something else until we have something definite into the indices. Just wanted to give you an insight of what is moving. All right, so let's move here to the 5 minute charts. We're already in 10 minutes into the trading session, your trading session. So today we don't have the environment that we had yesterday. Neuro open, Carrie. I see Neuro is moving right now. I'm just watching it a little bit. I can't stay away from it. We have another stock that is moving again. It is up 39% on the day. That is WISA. Crazy. And Crocs, guys. Last year, Crocs was trading at, what, $20 or something? Now it's trading at $136. Crocs. FE First Energy moving higher over 5% on the day from the open, 1.62%. It's clearing the base on the daily. Microsoft made the list with the breakout. Moderna's popping a little bit. Still no trades in the indices. I'm seeing divergence in Russell. Russell pulling back a little bit more. NASDAQ is trying to hold. If the market is going to weaken, NASDAQ is probably going to be the last one that is going to start falling apart. Shop also higher, Shopify, and an analyst rating for a buy. Trying to find the strength. That's why I'm looking at some stocks to see. I see Shop is part of NASDAQ. That's why it's popping higher. All these names that I've mentioned, Twitter, Facebook right now, very bullish as well. They're gaining a little bit of momentum. There's a block trade in UAL at $48.10. Right now, the stock is trading $47.62. Kevin, is it? Crazy, right? Yeah, the scanner is pretty impressive because you could catch some really awesome moves off of it. If you're a stock day trader, oh my gosh, I wish I had something like this. Like I'm still using right now Trade Ideas for a scanner. You guys know that I've always been using it, but this is a little bit more complex because it gives you like a lot of other information that a regular scanner is not. There was another scanner around, Match Scan or something like that. I don't even know if they're around. Okay, so the market is popping a little bit here. So let's see what we're looking at. NASDAQ is runaway. I didn't want to get NASDAQ aggressively because, like I said, none of these indices were literally moving in sync with it. So it was the only runner up. All right, so NASDAQ right now has like literally mission accomplished. 14,895 area for resistance. We talked about this area of resistance, and this is actually the top right here, and you can see how quickly it pulled back. Look at the volatility in it. Look at this 5-minute bar, guys. I mean, this is incredible. The low is 865 and the high is 894.95. It's crazy. And it's moving so, so fast. And this is one bar. This is one bar. Just crazy move. All right, NASDAQ is reacting off of that resistance. Let's see if we get a pullback in NASDAQ. Definitely NASDAQ, super strong. Not a big fan of the way things are moving. They're not in sync today. We have a 15-minute doji in YM that has already triggered the low of this doji. So let's see, the pivot support right now is into the 550. 550 and the trigger would be over 700. No, thanks. All right. So Dow needs to stabilize a little bit before we actually try to find a trade in it. Moving on to the mini S&P. Mini S&P 15-minute high low. Interesting here, just ahead of that bullish above level. Yeah, I think that the only option here would be ES, but let's see, would it be over 55, over 43.55 with a stop 44, a little over 10 point range. Right now, the 5 minute is trading into the 200 simple moving average and the 50. You see the 30 minute. 30 minute is respecting the 15 so far. So we have 10 more minutes for this candle to close. Yeah, these are going to be pretty much the parameters. So it's going to be over 55. But not now, just wait a little bit because we need to see some candles close in here. Oops, sorry about that, I did that. I wanted to grab the chat box, okay. The weekly is looking good. The daily has already triggered in all the indices, so they look higher. Over 55, it's regaining the bullish momentum. So let's just wait for that. Not loving Russell here because Russell has a lot of weakness that are, it's already down 1%. Rest of the indices are definitely not in sync. Take a look at Nasdaq. Nasdaq is up 0.30%. Today is a lot more difficult to trade than the prior 2 days, 2 to 3 days even. Let's see if we have a trade or not. Very wicked market so far. Absolutely nothing to trade right now. We're just watching. No shorts yet. Wow, look at the volatility. Lots of topping tails, lots of bottoming tails. All right, moment of truth, kind of like this candle right here. Into NASDAQ. NASDAQ long, 878.5, NASDAQ long, 878.5. First target, 888. 894. We have three targets, 888. 890, full size. Let's see how it's digesting the 84 to 85. We need the other indices to start participating and they're not. This is super aggressive. Based on relative strength, pattern formation. And because it pulled back to the bullish above level, which right now represents minor support. Actually, I would be happy today with an 888 and be done in NASDAQ. We're at 81 and a half. No, yes, no, doesn't qualify. Remember, these targets are areas. There's no such thing in existence as an exact target, but these are pretty exact with our levels. But just so you know, in trading in general, there is no, okay, it's got to get to an 888. And if it's going to 887, that's not considered target. It is considered target area. So be ready to pull the trigger into that zone. I try to make it as precise, like laser precise as possible. We're at 85. I'm dumping half at 88, just so you know. Wow, that was fast. That was fast. That was fast. That was fast. Stay in, stay in, stay in. Only have one little lot left. Wowzers. Wowzers. Awesome. Awesome. Stay in. I'm still in with a little lot. Still in with a little lot. There was a huge algo pop-up. Stay in. We're almost at 900. We have already triggered the 15 minute. We have rolled, rolled, rolled. Randy, you are rocking and rolling. Have a great day, Randy. Talk to you soon. Do something fun. I hope it's fun. Thanks. The one, okay, here's the deal, guys. Let's put the trail stop. Last slot. Hold on to it. Hold on to it. 10 seconds. 10 seconds to go. 10 seconds. Come on. We need to hold this area. 10 seconds. Not that hard. We had a nice pop up. Last trail. So we have hit all targets. Old targets. If you're out, you're out. But if you're still in, I want to use the trail stop of 8, 8.87. Trail stop, 8.87. We're looking for that whole number of 14,900. So from this point, we're in full trail mode. We have been helped by an algo, by the way. There was some heavy accumulation of 3,371 contracts at the pop-up right after we got in. After we got in. So the institutions hopped in after we got in. That's pretty awesome. 15 seconds and we're going to be reducing, we're going to be lifting the stop up. 10 seconds. The stop is going to be 90, but it's going to be in two. Okay. 90 right now, 90 stop, 890 stop. Done. We're done. Wow. What the heck is up with this market? We're done. We're completely done. Completely done. Wow. Too crazy. Very volatile market, not in sync. This is a chaotic market. Wow. Don't trade this on your own. I mean, I'm telling you, this is just really, really crazy. Oh my gosh, Lori. Awesome. Good job. Good job. I love when I hear that. Oh my gosh. Now I can breathe. It was literally, I was holding my breath for this. See, it's the only index that went. The only index that went. We're done. We're done. Awesome. Awesome. I'm literally done for the day. Cardio. I am telling you, Martin, this was literally cardio. Okay. So, because we have new members, I just wanted to remind everyone that if you guys are trading micros, always perform your analysis on the full size contract and the levels that I am posting for the trades for the full size contract are for the full size contract. And if you're trading micros, please add 2 to 3 ticks to the upside above my entry for micros. And for the stop, give a few ticks as well, a couple of ticks, 2 to 3 ticks, because it's a volatile market. Take a look at the volatility and the chop. The pattern here was a pullback and it was a pullback buy off the doji. It was into the minor support deriving from this bullish above area. And that's why we had a little bit of room all the way to 94.95 right here into prior resistance. The reason why we chose NASDAQ is because it had relative strength and it was a little bit better structured than the rest of the indices. Notice that the E-mini S&P has a bullish above area into the 43.61. So it has a long ways to go into that area. It also has a death cross right here into the 55 to 54. So we needed to take this out. I know there was a question in here about the E-mini S&P, and I said no, because it doesn't support the structure because of this resistance. And you could see that we're having a little bit of a meltdown right now. NYM support still going within an uptrend. So I'm not really sure that the market is really going to give it a pull back now, or the structure is, again, very, very delicate right now. We're still having a lot of stocks that have incredible strength. Like I said, Apple, Google, Facebook, Twitter as well. Twitter is back into the $70, trading very strong. Microsoft is higher. And AMD is higher, is just coiling into that $90, $89 to $90. Cisco is again back into the top of the range. So we still have some strength into the NASDAQ stocks. The Dow stocks are a little bit more under pressure this morning. I'm not saying that they're bearish, but they are a little bit into the red. For example, Boeing is back into the 200 simple moving average, back into that $220 right now, $219.92. Disney as well is trading under pressure from the resistance from yesterday's trading session. Yesterday, we had a doji that poked into the 50 SMA, and now it's rotating back down. So we have a little bit of sidewaysness into these Dow stocks. Dow's pretty much holding. All right, let's take a look at financials. JP Morgan is back into resistance. The resistance is from the big range that it had developed last week. And we had the breakdown this week. We revisited a prior low. So we're basically into a structure of a triple bottom on the daily. And if we are going to take out the 150 today in JP Morgan, for example, then the stock will most likely continue a little bit lower. So that means that we may have extra pressure in ES for the downside. And in general, financials are still holding. By the way, Morgan Stanley, incredibly strong with a brand new high, 96.23 today. So very, very strong. I would not totally just put these financials on the do not trade list, but they're definitely on high watch. Intel is holding pretty well right now. Caterpillar is very sideways, still having resistance from the 20 SMA. So that's part of YM. And UNH sideways. So this is kind of like a little bit of a, you know, watch of what's moving and what's what is higher, what is lower for today's trading session. All right, let's take a quick look here and see where we're at with the scanner. I'm just gonna have to give a little bit of refresh here. Let's see. All right, the market is definitely, this is not the market that I want to trade. I'm going to give you a watch, for example, for the E-mini S&P in case the E-mini S&P is going to rev up. If it trades above this candle high of 43.56, so it needs to get over 43.56. I'm going to put an alert here. It may start going a little bit higher. I don't want to be here all day in front of the computer, but if it goes above 56, it's going to go higher, most likely challenge the 61. So you're going to have, if you have an entry at 56, you're going to have a target into 60. And if it gets over 60, it has room to go into the 70s. So you can see that it has a nice juicy tradable void right here. The stop that needs to be applied is going to be below that 44 that I mentioned earlier. 43.44, but it really needs to close above here. So we still have 45 minutes into this 1 hour for the price to close above 56, but it can trigger above. And if it definitely, if it triggers above, it has more chances of closing above this flat 200 symbol moving average here. So you can see it from here. So that's going to be a lot of resistance for price. All right. And at this point, anything that will trade. So the way I see this, if you want to take this, for example, because it's kind of like coming in right now. So the way I see it, you could take half the size into 56, put the stop into 43. And then if it gets over 62, add the other half in because it's going to be part of the breakout. and scale some out as you're going into the 67 to 70. That's the only game plan that I'm seeing for today. But again, the 1 hour, like I said, it has a lot of resistance here. Let's see how it's digesting that. If it's going to trigger this point, it's going to be much better for price. Also, if you're looking at the 30 minute has this pretty much the same structure. So it needs to get up and break that 56 level. It breaks the 56, it's going to go higher. If it's not going to break the 56, it's not going to go anywhere. The only thing that I'm a little bit afraid of today is possibly trigger and failure. So it can pop up and then pull back again. Okay, because it's today we have a little bit of a choppier environment than we had yesterday and the day before. We made our money. So listen, this is like, even if you caught only 10 points in NASDAQ, I mean, that's a huge win in a market like today. A lot of trade, I could totally see a lot of traders losing their shirts today because of this market. All right, let's take a quick look and let me give you my take on the Dow. Dow has a very similar structure on the 1 hour with the Doji because we had a pretty much back and forth action. If we trade above this high, which is 700, so we need to close into the 700 and you can see that 710 is still coming with a little bit of pressure. But if the price is going to digest the 715 or so, 700 and 715, that is going to be the key area. Then we can look for a potential continuation higher into the 740 level, which becomes a daily rotation. Daily rotation has not had any problems. This would be the retest of that daily rotation because we have rotated in the overnight trading. We have actually rotated in the overnight trading session and set a new high for today's session for July 22nd. And then we have the pullback. The pullback is actually coming into a minor support level deriving from this prior pivot high from yesterday's pre-market session. And this doji, if we trigger a buy, this is a 1-2-3 pullback buy. And if we manage to trade above this 20 SMA, the price is going to continue higher. Unfortunately, NASDAQ has really wide ranges. And I'm not a big fan of these ranges and I'm not a fan of whippiness. When the markets become super fast, I take a second step back. So not only one step back, I take two steps back because I do not like to trade volatility. This kind of volatility, especially when I'm day trading, when you're swing trading is fine, but when you're day trading, this is not okay because you have a lot of chance of stopping out of trades. And I don't want to give my profits for today. They were really worked profits. Okay. All right. I have some new stocks that are popping up for those of you guys that are watching the stock market as well. So, okay. So I'm getting, I'm having BABA on my scanner. That WISA that I mentioned this morning, still going. Vodafone, a little bit higher today, not really liking. SQ Square, is also popping up on my scanner. Wow, it's going so fast. I wanted to see something else here. Facebook is popping on the scanner as well. Facebook continuation higher. So Facebook looking very good for higher. Very, very good. It has a really good structure for higher. Okay, so I'm going to give you another idea. For example, if we start taking out this pivot, but we really need to close above 98 or above 700, we are going to continue higher in NASDAQ and we have room for higher. Let me take you back to the 1 hour chart. Okay, so this is the next resistance. Okay, so if you want, you could take a snapshot of these levels right here, so you can see where the next levels are in case you want to take some trades. Russell is back into the 2200 and it is not setting up so far. It is downtrending. And if all three indices are going to be a little bit more robust and they're going to turn around, then Russell will start popping up as well, but it doesn't have any kind of structure for a long now. And it doesn't have any structure for short. It supports more the short side because it's trading under the moving averages. But if it trades below the 2200 Like I said, I really don't know. I don't like the way it is. It still has support. It has, I mean, take a look at this. It has a golden cross. It's trading right into the golden cross. I would wait for the for this hour to complete. I would take a look, for example, at 11 o'clock. It's a little bit outside of my trading zone, that 11 o'clock. But this can potentially be a continuation higher. So I'm going to take a quick peek onto the 30 minute. Yeah, you could take it aggressively off the 30 minute as a short squeeze, but you have to wait 10 minutes until this candle closes, because right now your trigger is all the way into the 26th. You have to wait for a closer trigger. So don't forget that these levels of prior support now become resistance, right? So you're going to look at each and every single level of these as targets. So this is going to be target one, this is going to be target two, this is going to be target three, and this is going to be target four. So I'm going to give you the numbers. If we get a trigger, like I said, this is a really nice, but it's not completed yet, 10 more minutes into it. But when it completes, you're going to have a target one into 11. You're going to have a target two into 14 to 15, target three into the 18, and target four into the 20. This is going to be the game plan for Russell. Now, careful here, because Russell is the most declined index, is down 1%. So it's down there for a reason. I don't know if it's going to turn around dramatically, but it has the potential to see it's getting a little bit weaker right now. So I'm telling you, I am done for the day. I don't want to sit around here. The market is very iffy and very jittery at this point. Look at the topping tails and the bottoming tails. And for me today, this is a wrap. Let me know if you guys have any questions. We had a phenomenal day and also a really great week. We're chunking in profits and I really don't want to give anything back. All right. So let me know, guys, any questions. And this is it for today. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Same place, same time. Questions, no questions. Come on, guys, you always have questions about stocks or anything else. No questions. Kevin, we short when we have the opportunity to short. You don't short in an uptrend. Never short in an uptrend. We're out of breath. I know that NASDAQ was literally cardio. Yeah, we short when we have the opportunity to short, Kevin. As long as we're trading into an uptrend, we're not going to short. We wait for pullbacks, because that is when the institutional money is going to. For example, if you want to stay in our way of institutional money, it's like staying on the railroad tracks in front of a freight train that is heading towards you. That is how shorting is into this market. The money is being made to the long side. You could see that most of the stocks, most of the indices, even on the relative strength, weakness that we had on Monday following the option expiration, it was a calibration Monday. We had a very big rotation. You feel like you went to the gym? I do too. Honest to God, like I'm telling you, it was really intense. And by the way, we were very lucky because we nailed the entry and the institution saw that and they pushed the pedal to the pedal on the algos and we got out. And that's the key here, to try to get a little bit ahead of the crowd in the trades. But definitely NASDAQ remains very strong. Like I said, if NASDAQ is going to trade today above 900, it will continue higher. It will continue higher. These are the targets we can expect for NASDAQ. So it's going to go probably from pivot point to pivot point right here. It has a huge tradable void contingent on. And by the way, the breakout at 900, you're going to have to use a stop at 850. So you're going to have to use the same stop. You can't chunk it any other way because it's a big range. So I'm not going to stick around for that. It's way too rich for my preference. All right. Exactly, Lori. Yeah. You don't want to stay in their way. You have to have really clear signals, and we do not have any bearish signals at this point. The only bearish trade would be at this point is Russell, because Russell is a little bit weaker than the rest. But remember that Russell is trading, like I said, it's trading into a golden cross level. So for Russell to be bearish, it needs to break 2185. It is going to be bearish below 2185. So right now, still pullback buys are still going to be on watch, especially that is sitting right now on massive support into the 2200. It has support into the 2100, into the 2200, plus it has the whole number. Oil is not going anywhere. Gold is not going anywhere, like I said. So I don't see anything else that, yeah. Let's see. Scrolling to see if I've missed any questions. Let's see. All right, we're done, guys. We're done. Congratulations, we made money. And I'll see you guys tomorrow, 9 o'clock, Friday. And enjoy the rest of the day, guys. Have fun. This was it. All right. Thanks so much, everyone. I will see you tomorrow.